We're glad you're here this morning and looking forward to the beautiful day we're going to have. They said the wind's supposed to get up to about 40 miles an hour after a while.
It's supposed to be 33 in the morning.
Oh, well.
Oh, boy.
Degrees.
Yeah.
Got to be breezy, blow our door away. Anyway, we're happy to have this opportunity to share the gospel with you. And we hope that we'll be a blessing to you. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we ask you to guide us as we study your word today, as we lift up your name in praise and song. And we thank you, Lord, for the ones that have come out to share this glorious occasion. And we're looking forward to someday having the virus under control to where we can have everybody back in church. We thank you again for your support, your love, your watch care over us. Lord, keep us safe and in the center of your will, and guide us to this day, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Joanne, up to you.
I lost my list.
Go tell it on the mountain.
Page number.
Yeah, I don't know what page I'm on.
Oh, good look. And you didn't put that one on. Give me half a moment.
You don't know what page you're on.
No.
Oh. Oh, it's real money.
Good morning.
Hey, if you're happy to be here in this gorgeous Lord's Day, say amen.
Amen.
I don't think it's gorgeous out there, but it's a gorgeous Lord's Day. Every Sunday is the best day of the week. So, I am not ready for tonight, next week. I'm going to have to hunt up my, if I can't find my long johns, I'll just put some more leggings on, so. So who ordered this weather? You're fired.
Tommy did.
Tommy, she's fired.
You ordered this weather, you're fired.
So, ooh, I'll be glad when summertime gets here. It's just right around the corner. So, one of the, huh?
Give or take 120 days.
Yes, well that's okay. You know each day is less, so pretty soon it'll be summertime. So we still have our board of concern. If you know someone who is ill or having problems for whatever reason, we'll put their name on the board and just continue to pray for each and every one of them. So, Missy, Kathy, you want to tell us how Miss Janet's doing?
Janet is better. She still has a long way to go, but she still needs our prayers, of course.
Okay. All right. Well, we just continue to pray for Janet. Probably Billy needs our prayers too, so.
Amen.
So, okay. We do have, and I didn't bring one up here. Those books back there are daily bread. If you haven't got you one, you want to pick up another handful? Sylvia, you want to pick you up another handful? So, they've got some good stories in there, so pick you up one. Oh, and I don't know if y'all heard, but the little lady Faye that used to sit over here on this side, she went to Kentucky or Tennessee, one
Tennessee.
Of those. Tennessee. Tennessee to move up there with her family, and I don't know, she got sick and she passed away. So that's all I know. I need to find out, you know, if they have an address for the family up there in Tennessee so we can send a card to her. So anyway, and that's that. I do know that she had COPD and she had asthma because I could see her some Sundays using her inhaler. So really don't know, you know, what caused her death, but at least she was a Christian. Yeah, so we know where she's gone. So anyway, is anybody getting any younger? I know there was something I wanted to say, but then forgot. So you know how that goes.
I'm getting younger every day.
Good. I'm so happy for you. Me too. I told my kids I was going to live to be like Methuselah. Oh, I got a long way to go. Long way to go. No. How about anniversaries? Anybody having anniversaries? No? Anybody want to sing in the choir? Sing a special? Come up here and take my place?
No. You're fired.
What? I'm fired?
No, we've got to have her harmony.
She's fired up. Fired up.
You think I would have? No. Okay, I guess that's all, you know. What's the next song?
Jesus is tenderly calling. Lynn.
Page number?
You never put them on.
Thank me. It's all my fault.
Of course it is, this week. 16? 315 sounds about right.
315?
316. 16. Jesus is tenderly calling?
Yep.
Now what?
316.
Okay, 16. 316. So on this last one, the verse, if y'all just stand up with that prayer after we sing this. I'm ready if y'all are. You gotta leave me out. Get off, get ready.
Jesus is calling the weary to rest.
Father, we thank you for the privilege we have of serving you. And Lord, as we continue this worship hour, we pray, Father, that you would help us to be a blessing to someone along the way. Father, we thank you for so many blessings you've given us. We thank you for the privilege you've given us to be here to serve you, to lift up your name. And Father, as we continue to face the pandemic, we'd ask you, Lord, to bless each one that has a part in our health care and in our welfare. Bless them, Lord, and lift them up. There's so many that are working so hard to treat this illness, and Lord, we know that you're able to cure it instantly. And so, Lord, we are asking you to be merciful to us and to remove this epidemic from us, that you would clear it up and set us free. We know, Lord, that we're unworthy. We know we don't deserve anything good, but you are such a good God, Lord, that we know that you'll have mercy upon us, and we pray you watch over us and care for us. We ask you to bless our country. Help us, Lord, that we might somehow or other get back in touch with you and get back into your good graces. We know that we have drifted away, but we ask you, Lord, to help the Christians across America to repent and to get back in fellowship with you, that you might turn aside the trials that we're facing. We ask you now, Lord, to guide us as we continue this day. Help us to do your will, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Somebody got you got a song you want to do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Deb's going to do one here in a moment, but see if you can do one. Push me, I'll do one. Don't push me. Tis the season to rejoice and have a great time, and
oh, wonderful, wonderful day. They are
You got something?
Me now to carry your son. I am waiting in a silent prayer. I am frightened by the load I bear. In a moonless, hopeless dawn, must I walk this path alone? Be with me now.
Deborah Fox.
Tis the season to be jolly, to celebrate, to be grateful and thankful, and to exchange gifts and all of that. And so I thought I would talk a little bit about some gifts this morning. Read a little story over in Genesis about gifts and see if we can't learn something from it. In the 33rd chapter of Genesis, you know, these two brothers were kind of at odds with one another because one of them stole the other one's birthright. he was not too happy because that happened to him. And so the younger brother, the one that sold the birthright, had to leave Jacob. So we're talking about Jacob and Esau. Jacob had to leave the country to keep his brother from killing him. And he went away to a different country and stayed there for a number of years. I don't know exactly how many, but quite a bunch. And he prospered in that country and became fairly wealthy. And he decided it was time for him to go back to his own country. And he was concerned that his brother would not want to see him, but want to kill him still. After all, that was the attitude that he left. So he planned a way to try to appease his brother. Let's look at the 33rd chapter here. We'll start at verse 11. I'm in verse 8. And read about it. It says, see what Jacob did, and then try to evaluate what he did. And so it says, and he said, what meaneth that thou by all this drove which I met? You know, here he, somehow or other I'm reading my wrong verses here first. Anyway, he was talking to his brother. He met his brother, and his brother was glad to see him, happy, and hugged him. Well, then he's talking about Jacob had sent a bunch of stock and gifts and presents ahead of him to appease Esau. And so he says here, he says, and he said, what meaneth thou by all this drove which I met? This is Esau. And he said, these are to find grace in the sight of my Lord. These are to find grace. In other words, I sent you presents to calm you down. I sent presents to you to soften your attitude toward me. Sometimes we do that. We send somebody a present because, you know, you take an apple to the teacher. Well, that used to be. You took an apple to the teacher. Nobody does anymore, I don't think. But anyway, he says, I thought maybe if I send you a bunch of presents, it would soften your heart toward me. You wouldn't want to kill me. I was afraid. He sent them because of fear. And Esau said, I have enough. My brother, keep that thou hast under thy stuff. He says, I don't need your stuff. I got plenty of my own. So here, the brother says, I don't need it. I've got plenty. Keep it. Sometimes, there's two items here that we see, and we find both of them. First of all, Jacob sent presents not because he loved his brother, not because he wanted to give him good gifts. He sent it because he was afraid. He had heard Esau says, well, I don't need it, keep it. I learned a long time ago that if somebody offers you something, take it. Don't turn them away. Because in doing so, you rob them of a blessing. And this is what Esau was about to do of Jacob. He was about to rob him of his blessing of giving. And so he goes on and says, and Jacob said, nay, I pray thee, if now I have found grace in thy sight, then receive my present at my hand. For therefore I have seen thy face as though I had seen the face of God, and thou wast pleased with me. Jacob's attitude has changed. He's not sending the gifts now because he fears. He wants him to take the gift because he's pleased with him. He's loved him. He likes him. Now that's usually the reason We send gifts to people because we care about them, because we want to do something about them, something for them, some little thing. So, yeah, you can give the king a small present. It doesn't really amount to much, but the king takes it because he doesn't want to hurt your feelings. And this is something that we need to remember. And so Jacob now has changed his attitude toward his gift. He is not giving it out of fear. He's giving it out of joy and the ability to do so. And so he says in the next verse, "Take, I pray thee, my blessing that is brought to thee before God hath, for because God hath dealt graciously with me, and because I have enough." And he urged him, and he took it. Jesus says, "Okay, I'll take it. I'll accept your present. I thank you for it." You see, Esau accepted it because he didn't want to hurt his brother's feelings. He wanted to help him. Now, this is a gifting season. Everybody's giving gifts to everybody. And so often, we give gifts out of a feeling of obligation. We feel like we have to give somebody something. And that is not the attitude that we need in our giving. And it's the same way with the church. When we give to the church, we give out of a feeling of gratitude for God, for what he has done for us, for what he's going to do for us. We are thankful, and we want to show it by the gifts that we give. And so he says he urged him. He says, "Don't take my blessing away from me. It's a blessing to me to be able to give to you." And he says, "Don't take that blessing away from me." And his brother says, "Okay, I won't. I'll accept it. I'll accept your gift. Thank you for what you've given me." This is one of the things that we need to know about giving. We need to give it from the heart, not from necessity. We need to give because we love somebody. We need to care for them enough that we want to give them something. Here I'm starting to run out of air again already. In the 7th chapter of Matthew, he says, and I'm not going to read it over the word, he says, "What you would like for others to do to you, that's what you need to do to them. If you'd like for somebody to care enough about you to give you a gift, then you should care enough about them to give them a gift." And this is what it's all about. It's all about caring. And it says it's better, more blessed to give than to receive. You see, blessings come. I'm thankful that I'm able to give sometimes, because there was a time when I didn't have anything to give. But I was always on the receiving end if there was anything given, because I had nothing to give. I count myself blessed today that I'm able to give presents, that God has blessed me. And that ought to be our attitude toward God, that we are thankful to God that he has put us in a position that we can do some little something for anybody. It doesn't matter who they are. We ought to give. You know, it says God loves a cheerful giver. God loves us to give cheerfully, not begrudgingly. If we give it begrudgingly to whoever, so we have lost our blessing. I want the people in the sound of my voice to be blessed. I want them to realize that God will bless us for our generosity toward others. We need to know that when we help somebody, somebody put it on a blog the other day, on Kathy was reading it, says, if you if you're gonna help me, don't go out and tell everybody that you helped me. Just don't help me. You see, we don't want to pat ourselves on the back for our generosity. We don't want to brag about ourselves. Let others brag about us. Let us others be thankful. Let us receive the blessing from God. Because God wants to bless us. If we go around bragging about how much we gave to United Fund or St. Jude's or whoever, we are patting ourselves on the back for our generosity. We need to give. He says, don't let your right hand know what your left hand is doing. Give generously from the heart, not from necessity. God wants us to be blessed. God says, I will bless you. He says, I will pour out on you more than you can stand. God has blessed me beyond my wildest imagination when I was younger. I didn't expect to have anything because I had nothing. But God has blessed. And God will continue to bless. God, I owe it all to the Lord. We need to realize that everything we have is His already. We need to realize that everything that we have been given, God has allowed us to receive. And the blessings go to God in that case. But when we share it, we receive blessings from God. All of these things, let's look over into the, what is it, got here. Third chapter of Malachi. He says, bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house. And prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. During these times of pandemic, the people are not going to church, they're staying home, or whatever they're doing. I don't know what, a lot of them are not staying home like they should. But anyway, be that as it may, churches across our land are hurting. We're not. God has blessed us beyond reason. But there are a lot of churches out there that are hurting because the people who are not going to church have stopped their offerings to the church. And God expects us to support the ministry. God expects His people to support the church. We don't believe in supporting the church by fundraisers and rubbish sales and cake bakes. We believe that the church is supported by tithes and offerings that are free will and given from the heart. And so many people today are not sharing their tithes with the church anymore because they're not going to church. So many of you out there in our listening area that are not able to go to your churches because your churches are closed down, a lot of them are. Especially across our area, and the church's expenses are going on just the same. I'd urge you out there to open your hearts at this time and realize that you need to support your church. You need to lift up your pocketbook and let God bless you when you give to the church. And this is not the total of my sermon, but it's one of the main points is the church needs the support of its members. God expects us to support it. God expects it of us. And the thing is, if we will be faithful to our responsibility, God will bless us. You see, giving causes God to bless his people. I don't care who you give to. If you give it from an open heart, willingly, God will bless you. We want God's blessing. People today are hurting all across our land. The food kitchens are running wild. They're not able to supply the needs. And there are so many people out of work. Maybe you know a friend. Or maybe you know somebody you don't even know. There's somebody you don't even know that as a person, but you know that they're in need. Help them. God will bless you for it. And don't pat yourself on the back because of what you've done. Thank God that you're able to share. Thank God that you're able to help someone. Thank God that He has blessed you to the point that you're not having to be on that receiving end, but you're on the giving end. God wants us to be blessed, and God will bless us if we'll just turn our lives over to Him. Turn this. I have noticed in my wanderings that in so many cases, the worldly people out there are more willing to help one another than the Christians are to help one another. And it's sad that it's that way. We ought to have our hands open to our friends, our neighbors, our brothers and sisters in Christ. There are a lot of them that are hurting today. Let's pray that we will be able to help them, that we'll be able to lift them up. And certainly, God says that if we will put our trust in Him, He will supply our needs. He says He feeds the little birds, and He says we're more valuable than the birds. So if we will do His will, God will bless us. And I'm thankful for that. I know that the psalmist wrote, says, I was young and I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. God says He will supply the needs of His people. God's promises are sure. God will take care of us if we will trust Him. I pray that you're trusting in the Lord today. I pray that you have received Jesus as your Savior, that you know Him as Lord and Savior, and you realize the wonderful gift that He has given you, because He gave His life on the cross of Calvary for us. And we are on the receiving end there. We ought to be very grateful for what He's done for us, because without Jesus, we wouldn't make heaven. Without Jesus, we would be without hope. Without Jesus, we would be doomed to an eternal separation from God. But with Jesus, we have the assurance of a home in heaven. I'm thankful today that I have that assurance. Not because I am worthy, but because my Savior is worthy. You see, we don't have to be good enough to get to heaven. We have to trust Jesus because He is. We take His righteousness as ours to get us into heaven. We take His righteousness to reconcile us to God. I can't reconcile myself to God any other way except through the blood of Christ, and neither can you. If you've never received Jesus as Savior, you have neglected the greatest gift that will ever be given to mankind. And you'll go out into eternity forever lost. But if you receive Jesus, your sins will be covered and you will be reconciled to God and you'll have a hope eternal in God's heavens because of his promises. I pray that you have Jesus. I pray that you're trusting in him. We're going to celebrate his birth here in a few days. We don't know what season of the year he was born, but we chose him. Somewhere along the way, they chose December 25th. I'm good with that. It's all right with me. Any day that we choose to celebrate his birth is a good day. Actually, we should celebrate it every day.
Amen.
Because without him, we would be without hope. So let's remember that Jesus is the reason for the season. And it's because of his gift that we have gifts to give to others. I thank you for those that are here today that you've at least listened to me, even though I rambled quite a bit. I do that sometimes, but at least I hope I got the message across about giving, that we need to give what we give cheerfully, thankfully, that we have it to give. And that we're better shaped than somebody else's. I pray that you'll have a blessed season of holidays here, celebrating the birth of Christ, the new year coming up. All of these things are ahead of us. It's a busy time of year, and probably have a cold front coming in here in a little while to help us enjoy it. Snow and ice. That's the only thing I don't like about this time of year is it gets cold. I'm with Joanne on that.
Yeah.
When it gets below 80, it's getting cold. I can stand 70 a little bit, but I'd rather be 80. I thank you for being here this morning. I hope that you've been blessed. Let's go to the Lord. Father, we ask you to bless us, to watch over us and care for us as we leave this place, that you would help us to do the things pleasing in your sight. Help us to realize the great gift that we've received, and help us to be cheerful and joyous in our giving to others. I pray, Father, that you would continue to watch over us and help us. I pray for those that are sick. I pray for those that have lost loved ones. I ask you, Lord, to comfort them, lift them up, and watch over them. And Lord, I pray that you would help us to be a blessing to someone along the way. For I ask all of this in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. I hope that you'll have a blessed afternoon.